This video is called B, factoring when A equals 1. We made a second video. There's just two examples on this video where we'll factor using the same method that we used in the previous video where we're trying to figure out what multiplies to give me negative 77 and adds to give me a negative 4. But something looks different about this problem. If you noticed that there's a variable here and a variable here, that would be what is different. It's actually not very much harder. We just have to break down two letters instead of one. And once you watch these two examples, it shouldn't be really an issue for you at all. Just remember the h squared is h and h, and what multiplies to give you a k squared would be k and k. So when you make your parentheses, instead of just splitting up the h's and putting them at the beginning, you have to split up the k's and put them at the end. Now we're going to spend time, just like the other problems, figuring out what numbers need to go in there as well. So we have to figure out what multiplies to give me a negative 77 and adds to give me a negative 4. So let's make our list. 77 could be 77 and 1, and it could also be 11 and 7, and that's all I can think of off the top of my head. Let's see if it would be enough. What could add to be a negative 4? Sure enough, a positive 7 and a negative 11 will work, because negative 11 times 7, a positive 7 is a negative 77. Negative 11 plus 7 is a negative 4. So in my answer blank, one of my binomials needs the negative 11, the other needs the positive 7, and this would be my final answer. Let's go ahead and check it just so we get used to that. It's a good habit to be into. Let's FOIL. H times H is H squared. H times a positive 7K is plus 7HK. Negative 11K times H is negative 11HK. And what's left? Oh, negative 11K plus 7K is a negative 77K squared. I have like terms here to combine, which will give me a negative 11HK minus 77K squared. One mistake. 7 minus 11 is not negative 11, it's negative 4. So that does get me back to the beginning, so I know my answer is correct. I have one more that has two variables in it. The x squared is at the beginning, the y squared is at the end in the third term. I know that looks a lot scarier, but hopefully now you can see it's not that bad. X squared is x and x, y squared is y and y. So when you make your binomials, the x's get split up at the beginning, the y's get split up at the ends, and you'll know that if you FOILed it back together, it would work. So now let's spend time picking what's going to multiply to give me 24, and adds to give me 11. Well, 24 could be 24 times 1. What else could it be? 12 times 2, 8 times 3, 6 times 4. 24 has a lot of different factors. Well, which one will help me add up to a positive 11? The positive 8 and the positive 3. So I'll have plus 8 in one of my slots and plus 3 in the other. Keep in mind, if you wrote your answer with the 3 in the first binomial, so your answer looked like this, that would be just fine.